So good afternoon to all of you. The topic of my today's presentation is sexual assault and their analysis, the drugs which are used in sexual assault and their analysis. I'll just come to my next slide. As the abstract states that the drug facilitated sexual assault are the voluntary or the involuntary ingestion of the drug by the victim without the knowledge of the victim. Basically, we need to know what is a sexual assault. Sexual assault is any act which is carried out with the victim without its will, with the use of violence, coercion, or the intimidation. They are also known by the various terms such as date rape, drug rape, or the drug in the alcohol facilitated rape or incapacitated rapes. The drugs which are usually used in such circumstances include the effects of sedative, hypnotic, dissociative, or maybe the amnesic effect. And these drugs are probably colorless and the odorless so that they get unnoticed by the victims. The most common drugs which are generally used includes the GHB, the alcohol, then flunitrazepam, rohypnol, and ecstasy, etc. The matrices which are generally used for such drugs to detect them includes blood, urine, saliva. Then they include any hair sample or maybe a vitreous humor sample or the vaginal or the rectal samples, etc. The problem lies in the fact that these drugs are not detectable for a very long period of time. Some are detectable for a period up to 1 day or maybe up to 4 days. Depending on their nature and the confirmation and the screening method. So we need such a method which include the detection of such method with a rapid screening and the more reliable test. So I'll just move on to the next slide. Drug facilitated sexual assault. So they are basically a subset of drug facilitated crime because they are basically done under the influence of any drug, which might be alcohol or anything that I just described in the previous slide. So they are basically a sexual assault in which a person is incapacitated or unconscious and they don't know what is happening to them under the influence of such particular drug. These drugs are very dangerous, powerful, and illegal. Basically, because they are colorless, they are odorless and tasteless, a person doesn't know whether they have been given such a drug. So they just take it and they are unaware of the fact that they have been ingested such kind of a drug. I just move on to the next slide. Date rape drugs. Ingestion of a drug by a victim that result in an act of a sexual activity. So these drugs are basically classified into two types, the opportunistic and the proactive drug. The opportunistic DFSAs are those in which a victim voluntarily ingested a drugs and the alleged assailant takes the advantage of the drug that she has ingested the drug. In proactive, the predatory DFSAs, intentionally the assailant person gives the drug to a victim so that he or she can take advantage of that particular person who she or he has ingested a drug. The most common drugs which have been used and which have been found in the literature includes rohypnol. The rohypnol is the trade name for the flunitrazepam. They come under the categories of benzodiazepines. They are sold in the market with the names of street names such as Roach, Rib, Roofies, Rofies, etc. Then comes the ketamine. The ketamine is one which is widely abused for hallucination and it has dissociative effects in the humans. The street name, which is, it is known as K-hole, K-kitkat, purple, etc. It comes in the form of liquid as well as in white powder. Even the rohypnol comes in the form of white powder in the white tablets. Then comes the alcohol, which is a very prevalent drug because it is widely accepted and socially accepted. So people just take it for granted and it is commonly associated with other drugs which are used in drugs of sexual assault. Then comes the GHB. GHB is also cited as one of the most common drugs and it has been cited very commonly in the literature. It is a depressant that have euphoric and the relaxation effects. Then ecstasy, which is also known as MDMA, is 3,4-methylenedeoxymethamphetamine. And it's third most commonly drug used, which is used in Australia after the GHB and the ketamine. And they have different screening and the confirmation methods. I'll just move on to the next slide. So the matrices which are used for the detection of deep-brain bug include urine, blood, saliva, the hair sample or a mouth rinse or a swab or maybe other sample which have been used by the victim to have a drink or some food. Then the methods which are usually used to detect such drug include the UV spectrophotometry, the gas chromatography associated with the mass spectrometry, which is MS, then liquid chromatography with MS, then capillary electrophoresis with MS and magnetic resonance spectroscopy. There are many advanced techniques that have been developed now, which include the UPLC along with the MS. I just move on to the next slide. Here's a flow chart which shows the toxical analysis of the drug in cases of drug or facilitated sexual assault. First of all, information is collected about the case. Then it is transferred to a lab in which it's seen whether the case meet the lab case acceptance policy. If it's met, then it's seen whether a particular drug is suspected or not. If it's not, then it's transferred or maybe declined to the case is completely declined. If it's suspected, then it's seen whether we have a particular kind of drug or not. If it's not, then a urine sample is collected. If in case the urine sample is not available, we do collect a blood sample. And then, and just in case the blood sample is not available, we do collect a screen and blood biological specimen such as hair, which is also available after 4 to 6 weeks. Then when we do screen urine, we do see that a confirmed significant finding is available. In that case, we do analyze for the confirmed drug or the metabolite in additional useful specimens. And after screening of the blood, urine, or saliva, or maybe a biological specimen such as here, we do confirm the report findings of a case. So that is all about the presentation that I wanted to present. Thank you so much.